This abscess has been the source of Amara Fosa's pain and discomfort for 2 years now. His parents say he developed a swelling on his right hand in 2020, but they never took it seriously until pus collected on the spot. They tried treating the wound, but fever, irritability, fatigue, tenderness, redness, and warmth in the area of the infection persisted. Worried and with no idea what his son could be suffering from, Tumuhimbise had him checked for cancer, but the results turned out negative. Instead, doctors diagnosed him with osteomyelitis, a bone infection.
Zimba akatanika no kuzimba mkono guona. Hati obugwazimbire yananka obugwazimbire gwahulika habwa amasira mengi muno.
Owen Bwambale, an orthopedic officer, explains that osteomyelitis affects all ages, but it is most common among children, especially boys. The condition can result from trauma on the part of the body, which, if not treated, is exposed to viral infections. The virus is then transported through the bloodstream to the bone, where it starts multiplying, and after a dead bone, medically referred to as sequestrum, is formed.
Disease, in most cases, it can start from trauma. Trauma, someone pops a wound, that wound gets infected with a bacteria called Staphylococcus aureus. That is the main cause for that chronic osteomyelitis.
Bambale says that Amara's bone infection is now chronic and his body is fighting to get rid of the dead bone. But the condition can be treated through sequestrectomy, a surgical procedure involving the removal of the dead bone.
When you have reached the stage of chronic osteomyelitis, whereby now the body is fighting to rid itself of that dead part, what happens? There is always a sinus or an opening. When it becomes a wound, that wound will always discharge pus. So in that very hole that is developed, which is discharging pus, that is the very point where the body will fight at all times to make sure that dead bone comes out.
While this bone infection is acute in children, it can affect anyone. Medical site WebMD writes that certain conditions, including poor blood supply, sickle cell disease, HIV or AIDS, and alcoholism, can increase a person's risk for osteomyelitis. This report was compiled by Jonan Tusingwire for the news.